Okay, we next have an application on geosteering inversion.
I'm a PhD student from University of Houston, and this is the first time I give a speech in such a conference. So if I could not express my idea well, please forgive me. My issue is about the combination of the machine learning and the physics-driven model. And our problem is the geosteering problem. The geosteering means we use the collected data to adjust the wheel trajectory during the directional drilling. During this process, we call the collected data measurements, and the electromagnetic wave is a good measurement. In this work, we could divide it into two steps. The first step, we call it logging, which means analyzing the data. And the second step is use the data to control the drilling. And but now we only concentrate on the logging process. And we have two methods for logging. One is on-ground method, and another one is underground method. And we would talk about them later. This is the logging tool for the directional drilling, and it has some transmitting antennas and receiving antennas. And this is an example of three-layer model, which means we could divide the underground structure into several layers. Each layer could be viewed as an individual and homogeneous media, and so it has a resistivity. And between two layers, we have a boundary. So if we want to describe a three-layer model, we use five parameters. Here we call the five parameters the Earth model. Although there is another parameter, the deep angle, but we to simplify the problem, we set the deep angle 90 degrees. And this is the transmission of the electromagnetic wave. There are many transmitters and receivers, so that if the Earth model changes, the measurements would also change. This is our geosteering inverse problem. If we could build a EM forward model function F. Here F accept the Earth model, and it would produce 92 values. The 92 values is the measurements. The function F is built with the Maxwell equations. But in our case, we only know the measurements Y, but we don't know the Earth model X. If we want to know the Earth model X, we need to do the optimization. In the optimization, we often use the first order gradient, and we use the equation 2 to describe it. And the partial F over partial X is the Jacobian matrix of the forward model. In this application, we have some challenges. The first, we have mentioned that there are two methods for the geosteering logging. But if we use the on-ground method, which means we could use a powerful and advanced machine to process the data, but we need to wait the data transmitted back to the ground. This would take a lot of time. If we use this method, our data is not adequate. But we also could process the data underground directly. If we use this method, we could not use the advanced machine because in the underground condition, the environmental condition is very bad. We could not use a very powerful machine due to the limitation of the condition. So if we perform the optimization underground, we do not have the time to wait the optimization get converged. this is the data transmission method for the on-ground method. Because we need to use the mechanical wave to get data back, and so the model pulse is very slow. We could not get enough data in time. If we use the underground method, in some previous work, we use the lookup table, which means we first generate a lot of samples in the whole data space, and for each sample, we use the fold model function to get the measurements, and we store them. If we get a new measurement, we would compare the measurement with all the measurements in the table, and then we find the best match one. So we could infer the Earth model, but we could not generate a very dense table, because if the density of the table increase, the computational cost and the memory cost would increase exponentially. Some people have made progress on this on neural network, but our network has two differences compared to their works. The first one is we use the 1D convolutional network in the deep network. We have known that the convolutional network has been widely used for processing image, but when we processing the vectors, we usually use fully connected network. But here we borrow the idea of the 2D convolutional network into the 1D case, which means we use a short vector as the kernel to perform the convolution, so that we could use fewer parameters to learn the local pattern of the data. Another improvement is that we introduced the fold model in our architecture. We know that traditional neural network is data driven, which means we only perform the supervised learning with the model misfit. But in this case, we could only learn the inverse function of the fold model by learning the statistical distribution of the training set. But here we implement the fold model in our architecture, which would introduce another misfit, which means the data misfit. With the data misfit, we could optimize with the fold model directly. And why with the fold model the performance could be improved? We could look at the fold model function. This is the feed forward. This is the feed forward process of the fold model function. In this process, we could view the function as a black box. It accepts the Earth model and produces the measurements. But in the back propagate process, we could assume that the gradient from the next layer has been none, which means the loss function, the gradient of the loss function over the output of this black box has been none. So we could calculate the Jacobian matrix and use the Jacobian matrix to backpropagate the loss function backpropagate the gradient of the loss function to the input space. So with these two improvements, our network could be used in real applications, because first, with the network deployment, we could use it underground, because it could be calculated fast, and it only takes a very small amount of memory compared to the optimization process, because it could be run underground, so it could get access to the whole data, and compared to the lookup table, it could get a higher accuracy with a lower computational cost and a lower memory cost. Here is an example of the result. The x-axis is the several points. Every point means 1 feet, And the y-axis is the is the depth. And if we look at the result, we could know that there are 80 points. The lookup table could not reach a good solution because the table is very coarse. But if you look at the result with the data-driven network, we could find that also the boundary could be predicted well. But when the boundary is near to the tool, the resistivity is not very good. But with our solution, both the resistivity and the boundary is good are good. And if we input the predicted Earth model into that EM fold model function, and we could produce the synthetic measurements. These data are picked from the synthesis synthetic measurements, and we could use these curves to find the data misfit. And the left side is with our physics engine, and we could see that with introducing the forward function, the data misfit could be lower. And to prove our architecture could achieve the good performance in many cases, we generate 100 samples randomly. And we use the evaluation of the model misfit as the x-axis and the data misfit as the y-axis. Then each point means the evaluation of a sample. A sample means 80 points, just like before. So you could see that the green points are the result from the lookup table. Both the data and model misfit are very high. But with our proposed architecture, we could see that both the data misfit and the model misfit are the lowest. That's all. Thank you. If you have the questions.
I have one. Can you think of any other similar kinds of problems you could apply the same technology to? Have you thought about that?
Yeah, because here, also here, we use an electromagnetic forward model function. But this function is a black box here. So we could use another function to replace it. But no matter what function we use, this function should be differentiable. So we could calculate the gradient of it, and we believe that with the forward model function, the network could predict a better result because it could be updated with the gradient from the forward model function. Here, the forward model function could serve as the decoder part of an autoencoder structure.
Could the forward model be a neural network model?
No, the forward model.
I mean, not a adaptive one. It's frozen, but because it's differentiable.
Yeah, the forward model here is not a network, but it could be a network. But why we use a defined function? Because this forward model is defined by Maxwell equations. If we introduce such a function, we could introduce the physical meaning of the specific problem. If you want to solve another specific problem, you could use another function. Yeah.
Well, the issue is that finding a model that's differentiable kind of limits the space where you can apply this, and where you can take a neural network and clone a theoretical model to some high degree, and then even that model now is differentiable. Because some models are intractable to differentiation.
Sometimes maybe a function is not differentiable, but here we could believe that the network could serve as the could learn from the gradient, somehow, yeah.
Just to answer the question about the differential model, right? So actually, you can use surrogate, right? Because what we use here right now is a very fast forward model, right? It only takes about a few seconds to run. But if you're running a big model, right, it's not a very very feasible to train a network like this, so that you could use a surrogate model, right? And also, neural network is one of the candidates for the surrogate model, right? Or you can use a polynomial chaos or whatsoever, right? Yeah.
Okay, so you're saying that using a neural network model might be useful, yeah. That's what I thought. Okay.
Thank you very much.